Battlefield 5. What a gigantic fucking failure. From the horrible marketing, to the terrible community management, to the absolutely shameful game content, we're all just left wondering, what the fuck happened here? The newest information on Battlefield 5 is that the game sold less than Battlefield 1, and even less than Battlefield Hardline by a long shot, which just goes to show how badly this all has failed. I guess this is what happens when you go out and tell your fanbase to quote-unquote not buy the game and try to alter history to fit your SJW narrative. The most ridiculous thing about all this is that everyone knows that this is DICE and EA's own fault. But I bet my left butt cheek they are sitting over in their headquarters in their offices going, "But we appeal to everyone. We had the bionic armchair lady. We had the wheelchair. We had the LGBTQ plus groups. Why doesn't people like our game? We didn't have that many loot boxes this time around. You know, it wasn't that bad." Well, EA, I hope you're listening, because I'm going to tell you why your game failed so badly. Because I cannot imagine, in any known reality or universe, that you would have a big enough brain to do that on your own. The reason for Battlefield 5 dying is just too obvious. The marketing this game has had, and the group of people that the marketers have pushed this game to, just are not fans, and are not people who buy your game in the first place. You have gone out of your way to appeal to a new group of people, and you absolutely failed, and none of them bought your game. Obviously, marketers will always try to please as many people as possible. That's their job. But you know what? Let me say this. If appealing to women and LGBTQA plus groups and whatever is a way to attract more people into a game, that is absolutely fine. I'm all for that. But don't try to change world history by claiming that a lot of women were on the front lines of World War II, because they just weren't. With only a few exceptions on the Eastern Front of World War II with the Soviet Union and Germany, they just weren't. Obviously, women were a huge part of World War II. They took care of the kids. They kept the factories running while men were at war and died and got slaughtered, and they made up a huge part of the support corps, especially in the medical sector and also in a lot of logistical positions. But men wanted to spare women from the brutality of frontline combat to keep them from being killed, and I don't understand why today's SJWs refuse to accept that fact. But anyway, if Battlefield 5 wasn't a World War II game, I don't think anyone would have cared at all that women and disabled and LGBT and all these groups would be a part of that game. I cannot imagine that anyone would have cared at all. Like, just think about how many female leads and female characters there are in your favorite video games. Mirror's Edge, Resident Evil, Tomb Raider, Metroid, Star Wars, Watch Dogs 2, Legend of Zelda, Final Fantasy, Halo, Last of Us, Dragon Age, The Walking Dead, Half-Life 2, Bayonetta, World of Warcraft, Portal 2, Metal Gear, Horizon Zero Dawn, Assassin's Creed, and Battlefield 4. So people who claim that people who play video games, aka gamers, are sexist and hate women are just straight up wrong. But you know what gamers really hate? Being forced to do anything. So when a company like EA tramples through the door saying, "If you don't accept women in World War II, don't buy the game," you are forcing something into an era, into a game that never should have been there in the first place. Like, have you ever heard anyone complaining about Lara Croft being a woman, or that Ellie from The Last of Us is a girl? No, you haven't. Because they are absolutely amazing gaming characters who fit in their setting, and they're characters that we want in our games. This shit? No, we don't want this shit. If EA and DICE really wanted a well-selling game with these groups that they are pushing so much for, They have to set it in a modern era and tell a story about something cool and unique. So far in your games, you tell the most washed up basic ass stories to try to appeal to as much people as possible. The funniest thing is that a slogan for Battlefield 5 was to quote unquote, tell the untold stories of World War II. And how did they do that? By altering history, showing that a single woman took down the heavy water production all by her own in Norway. How is this a real thing? Let me do a quick TLDR, as most people in the world don't really know this story. You see, heavy water is an essential product in the assembly and production of nuclear weapons. And Norway, who had been annexed by Nazi Germany in 1940 after a few months of war, accidentally happened to have quite a lot of heavy water. So the Germans, also rather obviously, tried to restart their production and take control of the heavy water that Norway had in an attempt to make nuclear weapons. To stop this, a group of 9 very brave Norwegian commando soldiers sabotaged and bombed the facility without taking any casualties, being seen, or even firing a single shot, even though the facility was very heavily guarded by the German army. The sabotage mission is to this day considered one of the most successful sabotage missions in all of World War II. In total, almost a ton of heavy water was destroyed, and another minor sabotage mission ensured that the Germans had no more heavy water for the entire duration of World War II. Now, like I mentioned, that's a very quick TLDR. There's a lot more information and details in there, so it's not 100% correct, but that's the brief outlining of it. But imagine what DICE and EA could have done with that story. Just imagine the cool shit they could have done and how much praise they would have gotten for it in the process. But no, they made this. Because actually telling the untold stories from World War II? No, that would be sexist and homophobic. It's really sad to say, but I'm happy that this game is failing as much as it is. Because with this kind of progress, with some luck, we'll maybe see some better games in the future from DICE and EA. Although I seriously doubt we'll be seeing much of the good old glory days ever again.
So that was it for this video. Check out my Twitch if you like the shitty content. Goodbye, friends. Oh, and you should also subscribe.